So here's some of the trials, and I am going to torture you a little bit with trial after trial. Don't worry about memorizing any of the details on this, but I just want to point out that using stimulants in stabilized kids is okay. It treats the ADHD and it doesn't make the mania worse necessarily. Now, do you have to monitor? Yes, you do. Because can it? Yes. Have I seen it? Yes. But more often than not, I see it work well. And here's some of the studies. So this was Russell Sheffer's first study like this. Brave soul from Cincinnati. Bipolar spectrum youth. 8 weeks. This is when they were using divalproex more. A four-week double-blind study with amphetamine. Notice the robust doses of amphetamine. This is a mixed amphetamine salts, I think. 5 milligrams BID, so not real high doses. They're kind of like nervous about it. But if you look at that, ADHD got better with the amphetamine salts. Everybody see that? And if you look at the YMRS, Young Mania Rating Scale, no difference. They were the same. No difference. So in this study, with immediate release, mixed amphetamine salts, the brand is Adderall, there was no manic activation and the ADHD was better. So this was like the first study. And then Bob Finley did a great study, and this is looking at methylphenidate. And this was, again, short acting. Remember I made that comment about, don't forget our short acting congeners when you're dealing with bipolar disorder. And here they used, in kids who were on, only Bob could come up with this word, thymoleptics. So it's actually correct. It's on medicines to help control bipolar disorder. And kids who were euthymic at the time, which means not having mood swings and stuff, what they found is that ADHD, as they went up on the dose, 5, 10, 15 milligrams TID, they had the best response at the higher dose. They got a very good effect size for, look at that effect size, ES is 0.9. That's a really robust, it worked really well for ADHD, and no effect on mania.